That means a page of paper. Can you see this?
I have yes, sir. Yes,
sir. I can write anything, like say today's topic. If I want to write, I will write separation of substances. Now, separation of substances from what? From separation of substances. From two types of mixtures. First type of mixture would be homogeneous mixture. Second type of mixture would be heterogeneous mixture. Now in your textbook, the textbook which you have, let me mute a few students. Those who are like, you know.
To mute themselves.
Yeah, I'll just mute all and then after that I will begin, and whomsoever I would like to give response, I will unmute. Because small kids are also there, younger brothers are there, they are creating noise. Side by side, I request students also to ask other students in the home, other people at home, to not make noise around or to put off the radio or television which is working. Now, before I go any further with this topic, what I will do is I will show you the screen which the PDF file of the book is already there with you. So, what I will do is I will show you the screen once.
हमारी क्लास
Can you see this textbook?
Yes, sir.
So in class 6, you will find that the separation of substance is discussed in a very simple manner. Like the generally what we see in our home, like changing of card or filtering the tea by a strainer, isn't it? Or winnowing or hand picking or threshing. These are something which we already see around us. Now, when you grow up from class 6 to class 7, the same thing you will require to do in the laboratory. So you should be aware about a few lab apparatus like this tripod stand. Can you see this stand with three legs? So this is a tripod stand.
Yes, sir.
This is a beaker, and in between the beaker and the tripod stand, there is a wire gauze.
Yes, sir.
Function of this wire gauze is that it spreads the flame uniformly at the bottom of the glassware. As a result of which, what happens? The heat does not act pinpointedly on one particular point of the glass apparatus, which can lead to breaking of the glass apparatus. The heat gets uniformly spread. So that is the function of wire gauze. Same question. That why wire gauze is used, then you can say that wire gauze helps to give support to the glass apparatus first, and second thing is that it helps to spread the heat of the flame uniformly at the bottom of the glassware. Am I clear?
Yes, sir.
Now, slowly and slowly, there will be many cases in which you will require to apply laboratory methods of separation. These methods of separation which you see here, are the common methods which are shown in class 6 book. Now, how these methods are going to be used in the laboratory, that example I will be giving you. Assuming that in class 6 you have learnt and understood very well what is churning. Anita Jaiswal, can you hear me? Saksham, can you hear me?
Yes, sir.
Saksham, can you tell me what is churning?
Churning is a method by which we
What we do, we stir a solution with the help of a stirrer speedily. What happens? The particles in the solution, they undergo a circular motion. As a result of which, what happens? The lighter particles go away and the heavier particles settle down. And in this way, due to the centrifugal force, two particles available in the solution get separated. Like as Mata Yashoda used to do, she used to take out butter from the curd by churning, isn't it? So these methods are not new methods or high-tech science, but from there we have taken inspiration and we have made better methods. Like when you give the sample of your blood for testing, and doctor needs to find out how much of RBC and WBC is there in the blood, then what does the chemist do, or what does the pathologist do? They actually churn your blood, but that churning is not by the way as curd is churned. It is churned by a method called as ultracentrifugation. What is it called, Tyangsi Verma? Ultracentrifugation. What is that? Priyanshi Verma, what is that?
Priyanshi Verma.
Saksham, can you tell me a method by which blood particles can be separated? I just talked about separation of substances, and I gave the example of separation of butter from curd.
same.
But if you need to separate the particles of blood to test each of the particles, then which method is applied nowadays? It is ultra centrifugation. What is it? Ultra centrifugation. Okay, in which the blood is put in a test tube, in a tube, and it is rotated at a very high speed. So what happens? The lighter particles, they come up, and the heavier particles, they come at the lower
bottom.
Yeah, they form sediments. So in this way, the particles can be separated in different layer, and with the help of a very small tube called pipette, the particles are taken out and they are measured in microscope. So these techniques which used to be used generally by common people, scientists are using them in a better improvised manner. So in higher classes, we will be learning each of these topics in more detail with the help of laboratory experiments. Today, taking the reference of churning, condensation, decantation, evaporation, filtration, hand picking, saturated solutions, separation, formation, sedimentation, sieving, whatever you have learned in class 6, we will learn about the laboratory methods of separation. Okay, it will be more like practical. So we'll go back to the white screen again. Now here you can see the white screen now, where yes, we are sir. Going to discuss about separation of substances.
Yes, sir.
Now,
yes, sir.
When we talk about separation, that means there are two or three more components in that. We cannot separate a single substance, isn't it? Single substance is already separated.
Yes, sir.
So we can separate substances which are mixed. Please ask the television to be put off. In whosoever home television is going on, ask it to be put off. Now, the separation of substances can be done by two types of mixtures. One is homogeneous mixtures, and there is heterogeneous mixtures. Homogeneous mixtures are the mixtures in which the particles are uniformly distributed. Like sugar dissolved in
water.
Very good. Now another example of heterogeneous heterogeneous mixture would be mud in water.
So water.
So mud in water is an example of
heterogeneous mixture.
Yes, it is an example of heterogeneous
mixture.
And homogeneous mixture is
particles.
A mixture in which particles are uniformly distributed in the solution, like sugar dissolved in water, like salt dissolved in water. All
yes,
right.
Sir. Yes, sir.
All right. So, what we will do is, we will take two examples. Like, say, if you are given a task to say, separate water from seawater. What does seawater contain?
The salt.
Yes, sea water contains
salt.
Again, mixture of salt. There are many types of salts which are available in sea water. Now we want to separate.
Yes, sir.
What we want? We want to separate water from it. And also preserve the water. We just don't want to separate it and evaporate. We want to preserve it. So in that case, the method which we will apply.
Evaporation and condensation.
Okay.
Evaporation and condensation.
That is correct. Now together when we do that. Together we do that.
Yeah.
It is called as distillation. Together when we do evaporation and condensation to collect the water, we call it as distillation.
Distillation.
So we'll study about how distillation is done. Distillation of sea water or mixture of salt and water. Now for that we need to make one experimental setup. All right. As I have
yes,
a few apparatus, the few apparatus I will draw, I will try to draw. Now, I have a device here. It is called as DigiTab. It is just like a writing pad. I can write with this electronic pen, just like smart board, and the drawing can be made. So, you need to take one round bottom flask. This is a round bottom flask. All right. Have you seen this kind of flask ever?
No, sir.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
All right. So, round bottom flask is taken because the bottom, if it is round, then when we will heat it with the help of a burner or a spirit lamp, when we will heat it, when we will heat it with the help of a burner, then heat will get uniformly distributed. And to ensure that heat is uniformly distributed, we have to put one wire gauze.
Yes, sir.
In the beginning of the class, I was telling you about wire gauze. It's a net-like substance made up of wire. Helps to support the bottom of the glass apparatus. Okay?
Yes, sir.
But where we will keep
it? Yes, sir.
Where we will keep this wire gauze?
Yeah.
This wire gauze has to have some support. So for that, we will need one tripod stand. Tripod stand has got three legs. Okay. Like cow has four legs, we have two legs. It has got three legs to support. Now, inside we put the mixture. Mixture means sea water or salt solution.
Salt.
Now we put a cork. Cork means a kind of a cap, okay? If you have ever had homeopathic medicine, you will find that there is a cap-like substance which we put here, which can close this very nicely. Now through this, we'll make one hole and we'll pass one glass tube. we'll pass one glass tube. Now this glass tube has to be brought down in an inclined manner so that the vapor goes downward. Since I am making a freehand drawing, it is looking uneven, but this glass tube will be an even tube with equal diameter. Again, we can bend it like this.
Sir, we can't see.
All right. I'll just make it all right after some time. Wait. All right. Now to this, we will use one conical flask. A glass apparatus which is conical at the bottom. And here also we have to put the cork. Now what will happen? Due to heat, water vapor will be formed from here. Water vapor will start coming out. These water vapor. Now can you see?
Yes, sir.
Those who are not able to see, they have network problem. Those who are not able to see, they need to check their internet speed.
We can see it.
Very good. So, the vapor which will be coming out from here, will pass through this tube, okay?
Yes, sir.
But the vapor has to be made condensed. What happens when vapor condenses?
So it will come in its liquid form.
Correct. So to condense the vapor fast, what is done?
We put some cold water near the pipe.
Yes. And to do that, we use one another apparatus called as Leyby condenser. Leyby condenser. This is another glass tube. Although you are seeing it as two dimension, but three dimensionally it will look like this. Okay. It will be a glass tube through which the delivery tube will pass, and we can pour cold water from here. This will make the delivery tube cool. It will cool down the vapors. on cooling down the vapors, what happens? Water droplets will be formed.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Water droplets will be formed, and this will trickle through this tube and will fall here. And we will get what kind of water here? We'll get distilled water. We'll get distilled water. And what will be remaining after complete evaporation? After complete evaporation in the
salt
flask, only salt will be remaining.
So yes, sir.
This process is called as distillation. So there is all homework based on this particular chapter for you all.
Yes, sir.
The homework is draw a well labeled diagram to show distillation of salt dissolved in water. You have to draw the diagram and you have to write down five lines. Five lines you have to write down. So is the process of distillation clear to all?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Very good. Now, apart from your voice mode, there is also one functionality, chat. So you can send your text message also through this portal.
Yes.
Yes, sir.
So today my main intention was not to teach you science, but to make you aware about this platform. All right. That you learn to learn how to learn online. Learn to learn how to learn online. Now, this is one thing. Another thing is, say, if you are given mud in water, you can record the screen or you can take a screenshot of this because I will be clearing it. Can I clear the whiteboard? Can I clear the whiteboard?
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Yes, sir.
Now, next topic is filtration. Now, this topic comes from the example which is there in the book. Where tea leaves are stained using a stainer. Isn't it? This example is given in the book. But in the lab.
Yes, sir.
Say, if you are provided with mud in water, how will you separate?
Sir, using filter paper.
Very good. So, what a filter paper is? A filter paper is nothing but a paper like this. All right?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
A circular paper like this. Now, what is done? The filter paper is folded. First of all, we fold it into the one half. Then we fold it into another half. So if we fold it two times, what will it form? It will form a cone or not? Just like a joker's cap?
Yes, sir.
It will form a cone,
sir.
Like this.
Yes,
form a cone like this. Now this cone, it can be put into a funnel. How many of you have seen funnel? When oil is poured in the fuel tank of bike, You might have seen
yes,
that.
Sir. Yes,
the
sir.
Keeper, what he does?
Yes, sir.
He uses a funnel. So in that funnel, you will find that a nylon mesh is there. A nylon filter is there. So that no solid particles goes inside the engine. Similarly, in the glass funnel available in the lab, we put a paper like this. Now, after putting a paper, if we would like to separate water from the solid particle, then we can put the filter paper like this and we can pour the solution like this.
So we can stick the filter paper also.
Filter paper will get stick because water has adhesive property. Water will stick the filter paper with the funnel. All right. Now this is nothing but orange juice. I can drink now. You should not do that. All right. So in this way, the pulp of the fruit can be. Pulp of the fruit can be separated in this way. The solid particles from the liquid can be separated. Mud in water can be separated. And if you require to do any survival living, and if you are stuck in a forest, then what you can do? You can make your filter paper on your own. You can take a number of leaves, dried leaves. The dried leaves you will find will have lots of veins.
Yes, sir.
होते हैं उसमें जालियां
yes,
होती है जालियां तो उनको हम
yes,
एक साथ रख के कोई अगर पानी है अगर नदी का पानी है तो उसको भी हम अलग करके और फिर फिल्टर करके पी सकते हैं आप लोग देखते होंगे ज्योग्राफिक चैनल वगैरह में सर्वाइवल लिविंग में कैसे करते हैं
यस सर
तो इन द लेबोरेटरी यू विल फाइंड दैट देयर आर गुड मेथड्स गुड अपैरेटसेस अवेलेबल बट We can always tinker. We can always make new methods. So, like tinkering method, batao, ek jugaad batao, ki ghar pe hum kaise funnel bana sakte hain. Agar hume ghar pe funnel banana ho, to kya karenge?
Kisi bhi bottle.
Bottle ko ulta kar do, aur is part ko kaat do, aur isko khologe, to funnel ban jayega.
Yes, sir.
तो इस तरह से हम फनल भी बना yes, सकते sir. हैं ठीक है तो फिल्ट्रेशन yes, मेथड कैसा दिखाएंगे हम फिल्ट्रेशन मेथड ऐसे करते हैं पहले हम एक कोनिकल फ्लास्क लेते हैं कोनिकल फ्लास्क कैसा दिखता है ऐसा दिखता है ठीक है
यस सर
अब इस इन दिस कोनिकल फ्लास्क वील पुट द फनल फनल कैसा होगा ऐसा होगा ठीक है ये हो गया फनल मड है मड वाटर है मड वाटर को हम क्या करेंगे इसके अंदर डाल देंगे डालने पे क्या होगा वाटर इसमें से निकल जाएगा वाटर इसमें से निकल जाएगा और
यस सर
जो मड पार्टिकल है वो यहाँ पे जमा हो जाएगा ये सिंपल फिल्ट्रेशन का तरीका है ना तो आज हमने दो मेथड्स ऑफ सेपरेशन सीखे व्हाट वी लर्न टुडे वी लर्न टू मेथड
डिस्टिलेशन एंड फिल्ट्रेशन
यस सेकंड क्वेश्चन फॉर होमवर्क इज ड्रॉ a well level diagram to show filtration of mud from water. ये सभी कर लोगे सभी कोई?
Yes sir.
अच्छे से बनाना इसको और इसका टाइम है submitted between 5 PM 5:30 PM ठीक है? अभी अगर तुम लोगों के मन में कोई क्वेश्चन है तो पूछ सकते हो. अच्छा बेटा एनी क्वेश्चन? अभी एनी क्वेश्चन? प्रियांश वर्मा एनी क्वेश्चन?
नो सर.
शिवरान एनी क्वेश्चन? दर्शिल जैन एनी क्वेश्चन?
नो सर.
तो दर्शिल क्वेश्चन फॉर द डे आर फर्स्ट ड्रॉ ए वेल लेवल बोलो
सर. मड वाटर को ब्लॉक नहीं करेगा क्या?
नहीं नहीं, वाटर को ब्लॉक नहीं करता है. मड का रिटेंशन एबिलिटी बहुत कम है. अगर मड वाटर को अगर कम करता है तो अंडरग्राउंड वाटर कैसे बनता? अगर मान लो कि मड वाटर को ब्लॉक करता तो वाटर अंडरग्राउंड में कैसे जाता? तो मड मड जो है वाटर को रिटेन करता है, पकड़ के रखता है, लेकिन बहुत गीला हो जाने के बाद वो वाटर को छोड़ देता है. तभी तो जो रेन वाटर है ना, रेन वाटर वो अंडरग्राउंड में पहुंच जाता है. अंडरग्राउंड वाटर क्लीन क्यों होता है? क्योंकि वो पहले मड से सेपरेट होता है, फिर जो अंदर रॉक्स है उससे सेपरेट होते हैं. इस तरह से वो सेपरेट होते 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 अंडरग्राउंड वाटर प्योर हो जाता है, मतलब क्लीन हो जाता है. प्योर तो नहीं, इसलिए कहते हैं कि जो अच्छे कुएं का पानी है वो साफ होता है, पीने लायक है. अंडरग्राउंड वाटर जो बहुत डीप है, एटलीस्ट 1000 मीटर का जो बोरवेल है उसमें से जो पानी निकलता है वो है ना, इस तरह के जो वाटर है वो ड्रिंकेबल होते हैं. इसलिए तो कहते हैं, क्योंकि ये जो मड है ये फिल्टर कर देते हैं उसको, है ना
सर.